two, one, two,
intro.
Three.
My name is J.B. Eckel. I come from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan.
I'm Eric Dozier, and I grew up in Bakewell, Tennessee. We started a band, and we called it the Moanin Sons.
Hold on, just
that human salvation lies in the hands of the creatively maladjusted.
I kind of grew up doing the gospel thing in my little church.
For me, growing up, you know, music was more kind of a fantasy world. And it was all about rock and roll.
My biggest influence probably was just gospel music.
And full exposure to gospel music before meeting Eric was pretty much the opening theme of the Jeffersons.
In the sky, moving on up.
We met 17 years ago.
In Canada, in all places.
And we took it as a sign that we were supposed to actually do something.
While in Chattanooga, we went to the Bessie Smith African American History Museum and got a chance to talk about one of the pioneers of American blues music, Sister Bessie Smith.
And cultural center. I mean, it's a little everything going on here dedicated to Chattanooga around the time of Bessie, you know, let us know what happened. So
Bessie started out as a dancer.
Okay.
And she started singing, and then her voice started progressing, and she took over her mom's.
Wow, a topsy-turvy doll.
You make two dolls, put them together. When the master would come in, because they weren't allowed to play with the little black doll, the dress would pull down and cover the black doll. Okay? So when you're holding your arm, all you see is a little white baby. Then when the master leaves, you could flip the dress back up the other way, and you have the black baby.
It's messed up.
Please let me understand.
After she passed away, Billie Holiday was the next in line.
Yeah, and she cited Bessie as her
main influencer. As did Diana Washington, Mahalia Jackson, and on and on.
When the Caucasian race decided to build them a theater down
the committee.
The committee.
The committee on Market Street. They kindly gave the brand to us. So that was our first theater. I don't know if it's black on, but I'm the black one.
There's Curtis.
Sisters. Brothers and the whiteys. Blacks and the crackles. Police and their backles. Oh, political lackles.
What?
I don't know. I'm from Canada.
Because Bessie died totally broke. That. Janis Joplin, and there's a picture of the tombstone over here. Janis Joplin bought Bessie's tombstone.
And then she died shortly thereafter.
She died shortly after.
Whoa. Nathan Bedford Forrest, Confederate general, one of the founders of the Ku Klux Klan.
Yeah.
Gets his own statue by the freeway.
Coming into downtown Nashville, that's what you see.
That's what everybody has to see. It gives one pause.
That's what it gave me.
I like bacon, man. From the South, you know, I'm not with all of this, you know, I'm a meatitarian.
Bacon, bacon, bacon.
Animals are tasty.
He decreed that eventually we put our faces on one of these.
Heck yeah. Okay, take three.
Moanin Sons, going there. That music is kind of greasy, like bacon.
That's right.
Yeah. Maybe we should change our band name to Bacon. Because everybody loves bacon, baby.
Bacon, bacon, bacon.
I love it. I'll be taking that.
Nashville Skyline. That's a Bob Dylan record.
Oh. You know who did listen to Bob Dylan was Sam Cooke, man. And when he wrote A Change Is Gonna Come, he said he wanted to write a song like Bob Dylan.
Yep.
And then he wrote that song.
So there you go.
There you go. Sam Cooke.
And Jimi Hendrix.
Yes. Yes, that's true. That's true. So there were two black people that actually liked Bob Dylan.
Somebody gets slapped in the mouth.
The brilliance of it all.
Yeah.
If you will.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think he's Dwight.
Yeah.
We were up in New York City one time and we had a gig that fell through, so we were trying to figure out what to do with ourselves while we were there.
I had a friend up there who was pastoring a church, and we called that brother up. The dude, he said, well, why don't you come over to the church and play?
Harlem, First Corinthian Baptist Church. There's thousands of people in there, and we didn't realize it, but it was also the day of a huge march. There was some like 10,000 people or something in there, and they were marching all the way to the mayor's house to oppose the stop and frisk policy, which has been terrorizing a lot of people, particularly certain kinds of people in New York City.
It gave us that opportunity to be a part of something that was inspiring and moving and that was about social change, and to participate and unite with people that were all about that, you know, art and music, and even the nature of the service was just highly artistic and powerful. She hardly gets a penny, and then just enough for the city.
Yeah, right there.